everyone, and welcome to episode 2, season 4 of Motion Picture Meltdown. I'm Stephen the Roast Rosenberg, and joining me today, my faithful cohorts, Mark the Shark Hinton,
cohorts,
Phil the Kill Collins.
Did you forget what a co-host was?
No, I wanted to call you guys cohorts.
We're not cohorts.
Just wanted to use that word in a fucking sentence.
Fuck it.
Will you use it in a sentence,
please? Aliens. Today, we were going over James Cameron. Fantastic fucking movies. The first one being Alien from 1979, directed by Ridley Scott. The second one, and basically, if you haven't seen either of these movies, you're totally missing out. Wouldn't you two agree?
Actually, I'm going to be far more violent about it. If you haven't seen either one of these movies, I can see you have to have seen at least one of them for me to not want to murder you.
Yeah. Alien is probably in my top 5 favorite movies ever. And it's probably my second favorite horror movie, aside from Jaws. So
yeah, Philip, he actually said earlier that he watched Alien the other day and was totally just jerking off and smearing Jell-O all over himself.
Yep, and peanut butter.
Yep, green Jell-O, so it would match Alien stuff.
Alien, starring Sigourney Weaver as Ellen Ripley. Really the only one that matters, Ian Holm or Bilbo Baggins is Ash in this, or the android, which is the big surprise. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler.
Spoiler.
If you haven't seen it.
Yeah, from 1979. Spoiler. And John Hurt plays Kane, who takes part in one of the most probably famous scenes of horror ever. Basically, this movie is about a ship. What kind of ship is it? It's a cargo ship, right?
It's a mining operation, and they bring back a refinery and a bunch of ore from someplace to Earth. And they're all in stasis.
And they wake up 6 months early. Yeah, or half the time early.
The ship receives some sort of distress call or something, and then the ship wakes them up, and then they find out later why.
Basically, it's in their contract that if they hear any kind of beacon or distress signal that they have to stop. So they stop, and John Hurt, or Kane, goes out to check out the beacon, and he gets face-fucked by what's called a face-hugger, which is basically... Thing.
Face rapist.
It's basically Thing from Adam's Family with a scorpion tail.
The aliens are the weirdest thing in the world because...
Dick mouth.
A dick vagina mouth. Yeah.
They kind of reproduce sort of kind of asexually because they don't ever really like determine what the sex of the aliens are except for when you see the queen in the second one.
Right.
But, okay, watching it today, it's been a long time since I'd seen the first one. Other than, you know, the fact that it's 30 plus years old now. It still looks awesome for a movie from that time period.
It looks better than Star Wars. Yeah. It looks better than Star Wars.
Well, Star Wars was 2 years earlier, too.
I know, but it looks 10 years better than Star Wars.
Yes. Well, Ridley Scott.
I think
Scott,
it still holds up 100%. Like, it does.
Absolutely.
Special effects are concerned.
Yeah, it's not really all that... The only thing that I didn't like was once they found out old dude is the android, and they knock his head off with the log of cheese or whatever it is. That the dude
it's like a salami log or something.
Yeah. He knocks his android's head off, and like it's still all alive and everything, doing android BB Christy Swanson arms from Deadly Friend.
C-3PO.
Yeah. And then they finally kill it. Well, then they rewire it, and they super glue his head to the floor, and that magically makes him come back on.
Right. They have to cause some sparks inside of him.
After the little condoms for his wires, like the inside of his neck looks like condoms with air in them.
Yeah, how much milk did they go through in these movies? Like every time one of the androids die, they just spew 8 gallons of milk everywhere.
It's got to be what it is. There's
if it's
no
not
way.
Milk, then it's just really watered down paint. It might actually be that.
But or cum.
Yeah.
That too.
Apparently Alien was actually just a cover-up
for
the largest bukkake ever.
One of the best scenes ever, and this is, you know, everybody realizes the scene. It's the chest popper. Yeah. It's when John Hurt is, you know, after he gets face-fucked, the face-hugger, of course, dies, and he's all fine, and he's eating his cereal and stuff. He's like, and he's laughing with everybody.
As soon as I get out of here, I'm going to go get some real food.
Right, and then... All of a sudden, he starts compulsing.
Convulsing.
Suddenly, he just starts buying things.
He starts convulsing, and they put him on the table. And here's the cool thing is, if you've ever watched any of the makings of this stuff, Ridley Scott never told the actors that anything was going to pop out of his chest. Like, they knew that it was supposed to be bloody or whatever, but... At this time, they had this little contraption.
What a sneaky fucker.
Yeah, they put this little contraption on his chest, and bam, this alien pops out of his chest, and blood and guts are everywhere. And at that moment in the movie, you can tell that nobody knows what the fuck's going on.
They genuinely don't know what
everybody's
the fuck is
going fucking
on.
Face is yeah. priceless.
It's like it's the who farted face. Like everybody's looking at each other like, did you just did like, you do that?
Everyone
did you fucking fart?
Absolutely terrified. And not only that, but they're silent.
Yeah.
Like nobody is like screaming, everybody's just like
they're like did some kind of crazy special effect just go completely awry? Like what the fuck? What so, the literally? What
somebody
exactly
save this motherfucker's
fuck?
Still alive!
Right? It's absolutely awesome. And
grab that worm.
And the gore is fantastic. Like it is. There's no bullshit CGI gore. It's just all pig guts and fucking blood and
blood
awesome
and, just...
and little alien heads popping out of it. And then this thing scurries off into the darkness and sheds its skin within.
And
like,
does that little thing where it kicks its legs.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss, my wife. Baby, my heart's on fire.
Fucking yeah. Space balls. No, what I think's funny about that is like when the alien, which obviously grows 16 feet in 12 minutes.
Yeah, at least.
It grows into the size of like a full size man in like 10 minutes. Right. That is a frightening fucking creature.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Not like, only that, it's but born... it also defies the laws of physics, having, you know, being made up of nothing. It's yeah. Like, what does it eat? Like, why, how did it, where does that mass come from?
Yeah.
He's like suddenly bigger, but who knows why?
Yeah, and then not only that, it sheds its skin one time, and the skin is maybe 3 feet long,
yep.
Yet somehow when it shed its skin, it went from that little worm thing that blew out of John Hurt's chest to 6 feet tall.
Aliens, dude. That's all I gotta say.
Yeah.
Wizards or aliens.
Yeah, magic. Yeah.
Magic.
Science.
No, it's...
Besides that little loophole, this movie is fantastic.
I put it in the horror category. It's definitely sci-fi horror.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's oh, not... Yeah. I wouldn't... There's a lot of action in it, but it's much more what's lurking around this corner waiting yeah. for me.
And it's like the old school horror like formula.
Yeah, yeah.
It's kind of slow building.
Mm-hmm.
You don't really know what's going on, really. They're like, okay, there's an alien, but where's it at? And then, bam, somebody's dead, and they die in, like, a real creepy way. And the thing is that the majority of the people, when they die in the movie, they don't die in really gory ways. That's
right.
That's what, like, old horror movies did.
Yeah.
Like, it might show, like, the initial chop or slash or whatever, but, I mean, now it's, like, digital blood. All right, fucking Mario paint 7 gallons of blood into this shit. Yeah. Fuck that. Fuck you for digital
one
blood.
Of the, well, one of the coolest mm-hmm. scenes is, like, first time you see the little mouth come out of the
yeah.
big mouth.
I like to eat you with my little mouth, too.
Oh, now y'all get back up inside me, little mouth.
I wants to play, too.
Get back inside. I'll get you when we's eating them.
And strikes the dude in the throat.
Oh, yeah,
and
he, so good.
And it's just, it's like his throat explodes out of his neck. And you're just like, that is fucking awesome.
What a scary creature that has an even scarier tiny creature inside of yeah. its mouth. Like, yeah. why?
Your tongue is a mouth with fangs.
Let's not only talk about that, because if you fucking try and kill one, its blood is made of molecular acid.
That eats through the world.
Yeah, like...
Literally, just... It, just
didn't it eat through,
burning.
Like... Yeah, it ate through, like, three levels of the
space
fucking...
Metal.
Oh, space metal. Yeah. Dude, when you said space metal, I just imagined, like, Iron Maiden wearing space suits.
The acid ate through Iron Maiden wearing spacesuits. That's how bad the ass
would
is.
Would have, too, if they were there.
Yeah, not only that, but they have freaking...
The big scorpion tail
scorpion tails
things.
That'll stab through people and ring around their neck, and they can use them like an anaconda uses its tail in Anaconda. And
tripping
break
people.
Shit.
Yeah, tripping people in karate fighting. But...
Could sweep the leg.
Basically, yeah. Basically take the scariest fucking possible creature imaginable.
Teach it karate and fill it with fucking acid.
Acid,
like an
yeah. And make it angry all the time.
And have it defy laws of physics and genetics.
Mm-hmm. Be able to crawl on the ceiling and underground.
Yes. Oh, and give it a little mouth.
Right.
A little mouth is just what makes it over 100% of the
They don't thing. Have eyes, though.
No, they don't have eyes, but the thing is that, like, the alien is one of the scariest things ever, because any time that it shows, like, it getting ready to strike... It's always, like, covered in, like, drippy goo, wet
oh,
shit.
Yeah.
And it, like, snarls like it's the angriest fucking thing in the world.
It's like,
and
it's
an
not
animal.
Just wanting to kill him. It's just pissed at him.
It's just like, my little mouth is going to brain fuck you.
And that's one thing I am a little disappointed with in the series is they don't really explain how the aliens see.
Mm.
Or how they even really hunt or...
Probably like a predator sort of deal.
Yeah.
Infrared vision or some shit.
Well, they don't really need to. It's frightening. I don't give a fuck.
Right.
I know it sees me.
It did win an Oscar. Apparently, it won for Best Visual Effects in 1980.
Of course it did.
That's awesome.
Congratulations.
Honestly, though, one of my favorite movies. Like, you just don't get better than this as far as just creepiness, and it's not dated. It's 33 years old.
33 years old. Now, let me go ahead and drop my balls in your coffee real quick here, just real quick. H.R. Giger designed the alien in this, and he does that a lot. But he also designed the alien in Species.
Species,
yes. Shitty species.
Apparently,
Sean Connery
has made a return to MPM. Talk about Species.
But he did. He designed it.
The writer of Alien is Dan O'Bannon, who actually also wrote Total Recall, some other good stuff like Life Force. Screamers wasn't too good, but he did write Heavy Metal, which was awesome.
Oh yes.
But he did write Return of the Living Dead also. So he's pretty...
Some good shit back in the
80s. Yeah. Hasn't done a whole lot lately.
He might be dead, maybe.
He probably is dead. Let's see if he's dead. He's dead.
It's not funny, but it is kind of funny. Because we're sitting here, well, he's pretty fucking lazy these days. I mean, but he's
only been dead 3 years.
Yeah. You know what's awesome, though, is this is one of the only movies that has just a fucking badass tagline, too.
Mm-hmm.
In space, no one can hear you scream.
Yeah.
Which has been, like, replicated and, like, made fun of and, you know, parodied and...
Yeah.
Because it is so good and iconic.
Yeah.
And the thing is that this movie is so incredibly famous for its, like, what it did for horror, that so many movies tried to replicate it and couldn't do it. Obviously, Creature that we did not too long ago with Klaus Kinski's rapey Nazi ass.
Wish of a ripoff.
Yeah. And, I mean, the alien even looks like the fucking alien, only like the Walmart version, you know? And then Leviathan from the 80s that had Peter Weller. Even though I do enjoy that movie, it's straight up alien underwater. That's all it is.
Yeah. And I know you're talking about the guy who did the alien makeup, who made the aliens. They're fucking awesome looking, though.
Yeah, they are.
Like, the original, the way they look, they're better looking in the second one, because they had better budget.
Yeah.
And mortal, you know, it was fucking 7 years later. They're so creepy looking. They're skeletal. This is my fucking nightmare fuel.
They're space crawfish.
Yeah. When I was little, Philip used to be scared of Tim Curry's dumbass. I was fucking terrified.
I was scared of being raped by his giant dick.
Fire hydrant dick.
I was terrified of creepy, wall-crawling little mouth aliens.
I never said I wasn't
with
scared
acid
of these.
Blood.
I never said I wasn't scared of these.
I mean, these filled my fucking nightmares. And when I was little, before Jurassic Park came out and the raptors used to scare me, these are what filled my fucking nightmares. Alien 1 is just...
good acting. It's a 30-year-old movie that you can still watch today, and it doesn't look dated, you know? Like, quality-wise...
You don't feel like you're watching it.
Yeah, you don't feel like you're watching a movie from 1979. You literally feel like you're watching, if you've never seen it before, it's a new movie, you know?
Yeah. Let's talk about some of the clips from this movie. One of the better ones I love is when Sigourney Weaver is talking to the two maintenance guys who are real disgruntled, and we'll talk about that in a minute, but... You know, she's trying to tell them what to do, and they're just kind of smarting off to her.
Why don't you just fuck off?
What? And what do you say, Rick?
If you have any trouble, I'll be on the bridge.
What? Why don't you just fuck off?
Those two are extremely disgruntled, and I fucking love when you hear disgruntled people mumble about shit. Like, she tells them that she's going to come down and basically do their job for them, and, like, it's like two old men from the Muppets, like, going off.
What the hell is she coming down here for?
You better stay the fuck out of her anyway.
I'd like to see what she's going to do when she got there.
That's this motherfucker just got there.
What the fuck you say out of my way, goddammit?
Bullshit, fucking bitch. Fuck her. Fuck out here.
I do want to talk about something here, because Steven talked about how he would bang Sigourney Weaver.
And then he would die.
She'd kick my ass.
Now, physically, she didn't look all that bad in the 1979 Alien, but all of the things that I find physically attractive about a woman, Sigourney Weaver doesn't fucking have. She is the flattest ass bitch on the planet. There's no ass. None. Yeah. No ass. There's just ass crack and fucking underwear.
And like her bush is about the size of my hair.
Ooh, just Jufro hair, you know, bush. And then she has no boobs. Because they used fake boobs, like a boob, not even implants, in Galaxy Quest. Like, they just like, here, wear these fake titties under your shirt. Okay.
Well, I think she has a boob job now.
Well, I mean, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I guess so.
Just fucking aspirins on a fucking ironing board.
This is one of those movies, though. Like most horror movies, if they just would have fucking listened to her in the first place,
movie over.
Mayor syndrome. Mayor fucking syndrome.
Everybody would still be alive.
Of course they would.
And everything would be just fine. But no, nobody listens to Ripley.
Open the hatch.
Wait a minute. If we let it in, the ship could be infected. You know the quarantine procedure.
24 hours for decontamination.
It could die in 24 hours. Open the hatch.
Listen to me. If we break quarantine, we could all die.
Look, could you open the goddamn hatch? We have to get him inside.
No.
If she doesn't open the hatch, fucking Ian Holmes' dumbass walks over and opens the hatch.
Yeah, fuck him, android.
Yeah.
Milk dick sucking.
Let's see. We have one rule about space. Don't let the crazy aliens into the ship.
Don't open the hatch. Never open the hatch.
And then who does it? Of course.
They open the fucking hatch.
But what you don't find out is that that's the entire reason that the ship's out there was to go and get this organism and bring it back.
Right. Well, I mean, it was like a huge reason. They didn't just by chance happen to go by the planet. Like, that was the goal.
Yeah.
They were going to go by there and get the alien and try to make it into some sort of biological weapon.
Weaponize it, yeah.
Yeah, which is still fucking stupid.
Yeah, let's weaponize something that could just easily get away from us and just destroy
you don't
everything.
Weaponize nature. You right. can't do it. Which, I mean, I know this is sci-fi, but in that universe, like, this is something that's out there. Let's turn it into a weapon. How about we leave it the fuck alone? Yeah. Sounds like a good idea. You
remember
know why?
Remember when we trained attack dogs to attack you, and then Arnold Schwarzenegger just slams their heads together?
What?
There.
True lies. Ew. Trademark. Useless. Yeah. Cannot do it.
I remember being little, and when the aliens capture the people, they don't kill them right away. They actually...
Well, they want to turn... They want to.
They impregnate them so that they can have more exactly. hosts for their alien jizz worms.
Mark is popping pimples right next to us.
It hurts.
Alien jizz worms?
Yeah, besides what I'm going to do. I'm going to milk Steven.
Besides the... besides the look of the aliens, one part that used to just creep me the fuck out was when she walked in that room and there's just cocoons all over the place,
mm-hmm.
and then she sees the captain and he's just... It's like half his face is falling off and he's like, kill me.
Yeah, and he's got alien inside of him.
Freak me the fuck out. And then she just torches everybody with a flamethrower.
Yeah.
Should have done it in the first place, apparently.
Yeah.
Shouldn't have opened a goddamn hatch!
Exactly. But they... She gets away, you know, by herself in the escape pod.
Nope, cat.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. She has the space cat with her.
And I love the space cat. That makes this movie.
And you think it's over, but it's not over because the alien is...
Snuck into the fucking space pod. But it's drunk or something, and it's, like, not doing anything.
They don't really explain what's wrong with the alien at the end of the movie. It's just wedged into this little hole in the space
pod. I thought it got hurt, and then it was, like, trying to hide.
We don't know how it got hurt, though. Like, they don't really... It doesn't really show how it got hurt.
Hmm.
Yeah, but if it got hurt, why wasn't there acidy space holes on it?
Yeah, there's like it's just kind of lethargic and it's just kind of sitting there, and then she has to...
Maybe it was like outside for a little bit and got like depressurized or something.
Maybe it got hit in the head with something and it's just confused.
But she has to chase it out with like some steam, and then it attacks her like normal, and she sucks it out the airlock.
Right.
And that's the end of the movie.
Yep.
She climbs into a
incubation chamber.
Incubation?
Yep, that's what it is.
No.
Cryostasis. Yeah, cryostasis.
With the cat. And
with space cat.
And is awakened 50 years later to make aliens.
Yep. 57 years later, actually.
Oh, my, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
So let's go ahead and move on to Aliens,
Zizz.
Which is, like I said, from 1986. Directed and written by James Cameron, as you would know him to do...
Terminator.
Such movies as Terminator, Terminator 2, Titanic, Avatar, The Abyss.
And Piranha 2.
Piranha 2. Yep, his best movie.
Best ever.
Was that the one with the flying piranhas?
Yes
it flying was.
Piranhas. Oh my god, that movie was so bad. Did we ever do that?
We did. Fuck you. You obviously didn't listen to it.
I watched it. That was bad enough. I shouldn't have to fucking think about
basically,
it.
Basically, they find Ripley... floating around in space 57 years later, and she hasn't aged at all because of the stasis chamber.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
And neither has the cat. It's the oldest cat in the universe. Of course, Sigourney Weaver is still in this. Michael Biehn is still in this, or is in this.
Yeah.
Paul Reiser, who's a fuckhole in this movie.
Yeah, fuck him.
He's usually a fuckhole in, like, everything he's in, though.
Well, because he is a fuckhole. I'm pretty sure if you went and tried to hang out with Paul Reiser and be like, can I buy you a drink? He'd be like, fuck you.
Lance Henriksen's in this movie. We always call him the poor man's Chris Walken.
Yeah.
But he's a really good actor. I like him. And then Bill Paxton, of course, is in this, and he has annoying fuck in this movie.
And no one really cares about anyone else. And that chick that wears the headband. And we talked about how back in the 80s and stuff, if you wore a headband, you were automatically a badass. Oh, she was... I didn't realize that. She plays John Connor's mom in Terminator 2. Yeah. His stepmom or
What's
whatever.
What's happened to Woofy?
Yeah. I never noticed that.
Yep. Well, that's because she looked like a complete...
Because she looked like a dude.
Yeah.
She did.
She was Dyke City in this movie.
Yeah, straight up, like, just banging cucumbers.
Puke up my ass.
Yeah. So they question Ripley because they're mad because their $50 billion ship or whatever is crashed.
And they didn't get their alien, and they didn't get their ore, and they didn't get their fire.
At this point, they don't know that about any of that shit with the alien, about them trying to bring the alien back. Mm-hmm. And Ripley's trying to explain it to them, and she's like, she tells them the whole story like 5 times, and they're like, that's enough, Ripley, you can go. She's like, no, seriously, this all happened. And they're like, yeah, okay, you can go. So they dismiss her, and they strip her of her license, and they send her packing, and they tell her that this planet has been had colonies on it for 20 years, which this is the bit of the movie that kind of is just like unbelievable to me, is... They've been colonizing this planet for 20 years, and there's been people all over it. Family, 60 or 70 families,
yeah, at least
60 they said.
Or 70 families.
And as soon as they find Ripley, now these aliens just start coming out and attacking people.
After 20 years.
After 20 years of not doing shit, just now.
They lived there for 20 years?
Yeah.
Yeah. They said, we've had colonies on that planet for 20 years.
Yeah.
And, I mean, maybe there's a little plot hole there or whatever. I mean, regardless, it's still a badass movie. However, it is completely different from Alien. Like, this isn't a horror movie at all. I mean, it has some frightening elements to it, but it's not a horror movie.
Oh, no. It's definitely way more of a sci-fi action.
Mm-hmm.
What happens is they know that these colonists are getting eaten out, and then they take Ripley...
You said they're getting eaten out?
They get eaten now. They promise Ripley her license back, and they send her with, like, 20 fucking soldiers down to the planet.
Space Marines.
Down to the planet, and to... It's basically a kill mission. Mm-hmm. And recon, of course.
Right. Well, let's rescue these people. No rescue.
And Lance Henriksen is the android in this movie, and he's way fucking cooler than Ian Holm was, because he's not a complete douchebag. But you have Burke, or...
Yeah, Paul Reiser.
Paul Reiser. Who,
just douching it up.
Yeah, who was a complete dickhead.
I just want to point out right now that one of the dogs farted. I can smell it. It is awful. Oh, my God.
And it's a bunch of, like... Oh, the soldiers they sent down there are pretty much just a bunch of children.
It's a rescue mission. You'll love it. There's some juicy colonist daughters we have to rescue from their virginity.
What were college guys talking
about?
Yeah,
what's up?
Well, I mean, they are military. Isn't that what military guys do in the military, too? But bro, I'm going to get... As soon as we fucking get to, like, Afghanistan, I'm going to fuck all these Afghani bitches.
No, I'm going
to
ice them.
Jesus Christ.
God damn it.
I hope not.
I think the most annoying thing about this movie, and I will say it's realistic. Well, we'll talk about that in a minute. But Bill Paxton is just a fucking douchebag in this movie.
Oh, he's crazy, and he's a bit whiny, like a bitch.
Yeah. We'll talk about his douchebagginess first. Like, this is how he's pretty much introduced the movie.
I am the ultimate badass.
Yes,
state of the badass art. You do not want to fuck with me. Check it out. Hey, Ripley. Don't worry. Me and my squad of ultimate badasses will protect you.
Yeah, except they don't.
Yeah. And what we know
from... not ultimate or badass.
No, not at all.
Especially not.
Yeah, and what we know from Bill Paxton's movie career is that throughout the 80s, he was killed by the Terminator in the first Terminator movie. He was also killed by the alien in Aliens, and he was also killed by the Predator in Predator 2.
He had his spine ripped out.
Yeah, and apparently he's the only person that was actually shown killed by the Predator in the Predator movies.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, just pulled his spine right out of his butthole.
Yeah. Just well, no, Gary Busey, they showed him die in the Predator movies.
You have to watch it again.
No, he fucking cuts him in half.
Yeah, but you don't see him get cut in half.
Yes, you
do. You
just
see him fall apart. You have to watch it. God damn it. Don't... Well, fuck both of you then.
I think we're splitting hairs here.
No, we're splitting Buseys.
Gross.
Paxton does last.
Cubing.
He's one of the ones that lasts. When they initially go out, they don't believe Ripley until they actually see one of the vagina face, like, face huggers, and they capture a couple of them.
Instead of aliens, this could have just been called Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Oh, it could have, Philip. Oh, very good.
Oh, Philip. Oh. God damn it.
It's like, terrible jokes. It's like Ripley sitting there going, yeah, they bleed acid. It melts through everything. And they're looking at like holes with that acid is eaten through. They're like, oh, I wonder what caused this.
Dude, because, I mean, they literally took like this small squad of space marines and said, get in the ship. And didn't tell them shit.
Yeah.
And they're just like, here, carry all your big space guns. And here, Dykey chick, wear this headband because it makes you badass.
And most of them die in like a span of 3 minutes.
Yeah, at the beginning.
Yeah. And
half at least.
Well, they lose all their clips. They put all their clips in a fucking bag because they're above some kind of generator that if they shoot accidentally, the whole ship will go nuclear. They don't have any defenses, really. And these aliens are crawling up the walls and scorpion stabbing them and dragging them into the mist or wherever.
With John Lee.
Yeah.
John Woo.
John Lee. So basically, the only people left, you know, Lance Henderson, because he's a fucking robot.
Yeah.
Who spits milk.
There were more than one. There were three people left.
Yeah. Lance Henderson, Ripley, and Michael Biehn's character.
Right. And.
Paul Reiser.
The chick. No, fucking Paul Reiser buys it. I'm glad. Fuck him.
Paul Reiser he gets
face fucked by Little Mouth.
Yep. Diaz and Paxton are the other
Vasquez.
Two. Vasquez. Or
Diaz.
That's her name, Diaz. Or Vasquez. Yeah. Vasquez. Whatever. What are those Mexican names?
Racist.
Just another racist moment on Motion Picture Meltdown.
Yeah.
When Paxton's sitting there, you know, he's talking all this shit at the beginning of the movie, and then as soon as, like, a few of his squad mates dies, he just turns into pussy number one.
This ain't happening, man. This can't be happening, man. This isn't happening.
And this is like every 5 seconds in the movie. He's just pussy.
For the whole rest of the movie, just crying.
I know.
Except like, for when he dies. Like when he's dying, he's sitting shooting aliens.
Super badass.
He's like, come get some.
You want some here? How about you? You want some? And then he's just blowing heads off and shit. And then he gets sucked into the floor. I told Mark it was like being dropped into an alien meat grinder.
Yeah.
Basically. And then, and Vasquez, she sacrifices herself with that other guy.
Yeah.
And then later Arnold Schwarzenegger threatens him with a gun and he pees his pants. True Lies.
Damn it.
Why does he keep talking about True Lies?
I love True Lies.
James I love Cameron. That movie too.
Once again, Philip apparently watched the wrong movies.
I love that movie too, except for the fact that it's 5 goddamn hours
long. Oh, wait,
long.
Hold on, wait. James. I know exactly why Philip loves that movie. There's a horse in it.
There's more than one horse.
God damn it, Philip!
And Tom Arnold.
Yeah, that's a horse.
It ends up with, you know, Lance Henriksen and
Sigourney Weaver.
Sigourney Weaver, Newt, the little child, and Hicks, the guy who lost one of his eyes or something like
Michael
that.
Yeah,
Michael Biehn. Michael Biehn, yeah. They all end up, you know, at the ship, and Sigourney Weaver's still down there with Newt, and then you see the alien queen, and this is like double nightmare fuel.
I mean, scarier than the aliens.
Way fucking scarier.
Infinity scarier.
Like, 100 times bigger, fucking...
Giant scary head.
Slobbery face.
Slobbery?
Yeah.
Way scarier because she's covered in fucking slime.
Goo,
at least 27 little mouths inside other little mouths.
Just infinity, just...
Yeah.
And then eggs all over the place. Fucking, just face huggers galore. So, she basically is spraying her flamethrower. She's like, yeah... Give me my Newt back, and I'll leave you alone. Queen kind of understands that. She starts walking out, and then one of the eggs starts opening. Then Ripley just goes insane and starts lighting everything on fire and shooting all the machine gun bullets and then launching grenades into the egg sack and blowing it to hell.
Yes.
And you're just like, fuck yeah, this is just badass.
She's like, oh, yeah, that's what they fucking should have done at the beginning.
Definitely.
From orbit.
And they say that, too. Like, she's like, we should have just launched a nuke from orbit. And everybody's like, no, we can't do that. Or the Burke's like, no, we can't do that. And all the other soldiers are just like, fucking amen, let's get the fuck out of here.
Yeah. And the aliens fuck up the drop ship so they can't get out of there.
Right.
But the thing is that, like, right from the start, Sigourney Weaver flat out just goes, hey, we can't help any of these people on that planet.
Yeah.
But then which really, to me, says someone to help.
One person.
Which doesn't fucking matter because she dies in the beginning of Alien 3 anyway.
One second in. Yeah. Opening credits.
Gives
up face.
Fuck. Straight up just nuke the shit out of that planet. I'm tired of these predictable goddamn movies doing dumb shit. Nuke it. While there's a person still alive. I don't give a fuck.
Once again, another Mark, Steven, and Philip production where the movie lasts 32 seconds.
Yeah. You make it through the opening credits, you get one scene, you meet all the characters, the movie's over.
Yeah.
Hey, do you guys want to go to this creepy old house?
Hey, there's aliens on this planet. Credits roll.
You want to go to this creepy fucking house? Nope.
All right, yeah. See ya.
Hey, what was that noise in that house? I don't know. Let's go play basketball.
We've got to close down the beach because there's sharks in the water. Okay.
Hey, did you see that guy out there chasing those kids with a chainsaw? No, because I'm going home.
Yeah.
Okay. Movie over.
And I have not had sex or done drugs or drank today.
Going straight home, I'm going to fuck, drink, and smoke myself retarded.
It's like, I'm going to go home and finish my homework.
I'm going to write a book report.
And then tomorrow it'll be fucking Sally that's dead and not me.
Yeah, glad. Fuck Sally.
Why don't we write movies?
That'd be 2 minutes long. can you imagine what it would have been like if we would have went down to the planet and actually fought the aliens?
Yeah, so that's basically why we just don't make movies.
And why?
I guess we could combine all of our movie thoughts together and maybe make half of a movie.
Almost. We wouldn't get shit for a budget, though, because we'd be like, look, okay, here's our idea for a movie. Absolutely nothing happens and everybody's smart and no one dies.
Exactly.
Well, and people are like, well, who's going to see that? Well, people that are tired of your shit.
The problem is, there are movies where they get to the planet and they decide they're not going to go down, but then something happens and they go down anyway, like they can't control it.
Right.
That makes sense.
Yeah. But not like Event Horizon. Hey, this ship's been gone for like 70 years and it looks like it's gone through different dimensions. Should we get on the ship? No. Let's just tow it back.
Yeah. But then, of course.
Right. And it's just
off the ship.
But again, kind of like the first movie, you kind of think this movie's over, but, you know, think again because.
Mech battle.
Yeah, probably the coolest part of the movie. The queen is actually... Yeah, the queen sneaks onto
the
dropship, and Ridley comes out in this...
Believe it or not, she comes out with this...
God damn it, Phil!
She comes out in this giant mech that she's like used to using in the warehouse.
Like a forklift.
And then probably the most memorable line from the movie...
Get away from her, you bitch!
And then pretty much continues to just... beat the shit out of this alien with the mech. I mean, she literally bitch slaps the fuck out of this queen alien.
It's the slowest bitch slap in history.
Just spit my eye.
Dude, honestly, something I was going to mention to Mark earlier, it's like, this is a boxing fight, but it's so slow.
I mean, it's cool because she's fighting with this giant robot suit, which is just totally badass. But at the same time, this isn't a fighting suit. This is like this belongs in like Gen Pack. Like, they're moving around giant wheels of fucking styrofoam with this thing. It's
boxes
not made for fighting.
Shit. Yeah. I still think that the best way to get rid of the aliens would have been to hire a handful of Cajun people from New Orleans, because they'd have been like, ooh, these all look like the crawfish.
Crawdad man.
Straight up just would have eaten all the fucking aliens.
The crawdad man. Every day is a hard day down by the river. I gotta go get my buckets and fill my buckets up with them crawdad. I got you separated.
Give me a little hot bucket that acid blood, boy. You know, they can take it.
Speaking of the aliens.
Hire swamp people to do it.
Speaking of the killing of the aliens, let's talk about that dude who drops the ball completely in this fucking movie. I think it's Bill Paxton. After knowing that these aliens bleed acid, one of the aliens is like running up on them when they're all running into the car.
Yeah.
And the alien sticks its head into the car and they're all, and it's like, bah! And this dumb asshole thinks that it's a good idea to stick a shotgun in this thing's mouth and blow its head off, splattering acid all over everyone in the room. Way to drop the fucking ball, you goddamn idiot.
I don't know. I think I'd do the same thing. Big alien head come in and kill all
Turn
of us.
Turn the gun around and beat the shit out of it.
Still gonna be acid blood. Little
mouth. Dude, the little mouth. You can't discount that.
Yeah, and that's one part in the final fight that's kind of awesome is whenever she's holding the queen back and the little mouth's just like, ah!
I want to know if the little mouth is like a sentient being on its own. Like.
See, and that's one thing that I was kind of touching on earlier is there's just really never a lot of knowledge about what these things are.
Yeah, but
which,
I think that's what makes them scary.
Scariness.
That's true. That's true.
I mean, if you explained it, we know why they kill people. Blah blah blah. They're just completely.
They're Nazis.
Yeah, all they are is just it's a fucking simple organism, basically. You know, it just wants to breed And whatever gets in its way, it kills.
It wants the fish fucking fight.
But I kind of want to know about its anatomy. And, like, is that a sentient being in its mouth?
Separate from him.
I think you're going too deep.
Well, I don't know. Like, Predator shows you a lot about its background with, like, the fact that it's tribal ritual shit and, like, hunting and all that shit.
But that, I feel like that does make it less scary because you... I feel like you're more afraid of what you don't know than... Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah.
I think if you want to know, you should go read all those Aliens and Predator books that they came out with.
Do they have them?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm sure somebody has blamed it. Probably it wasn't James Cameron, but...
Yeah, or Ridley Scott.
That's pretty much all the time that we've got, and I think we all three recommend both these movies highly.
Extremely.
Yeah, don't watch past Aliens, though. Don't watch Alien 3, and don't watch Alien also has Renota Ryder in it, the fourth one or whatever.
I don't even like the Alien versus Predator movies. I think they're ass.
You can go see Prometheus. It's worth watching for sure.
Yeah, Philip says Prometheus is good, and that's kind of in the same universe as well. Mm-hmm. So.
Oh, it's definitely in the same universe. You kind of see one at the end.
Well, you know, you see one...
One of the Prometheus creatures is at the beginning of Alien.
Yeah, for sure.
But anyway,
the elephants.
Yeah. Well, and closing, I guess. See you next week, Stephen Russ Rosenberg, Mark Charkin.
Yep.
And Phil the Kill Collins.
Bye, guys. Yeah.